When I was 20 years old, I was broke. I didn't know anything about investing. I didn't know what a mutual fund was. I didn't really know how to invest in the stock market. I barely had $100 to my name. I would have killed for one of these. So by the end of my 20s, I had paid off all of my debt. I was investing into my 401k. I had maxed out my Roth IRA in multiple years. I was on top of the investment world. Like, I had figured it out. So how'd I go from being broke to being on top of my investment game? Well, that's because I figured out the 7 rules to investing, especially if you are 20 years old. And we're gonna find out what these 7 rules are right now. Now, most people assume that since I was a finance major, that I should have known how to invest, that I should have known what a mutual fund is, what an ETF is, how to buy my first stock. But the reality is that they didn't teach you that in college, at least the college and the classes that I went.
We're going streaking! Yeah!
So when I started my career, I didn't know how to invest. Now, thankfully, my career started with me becoming a financial advisor. So you talk about getting real world information, real world experience on how to invest. Like, that's where I learned everything. So when I made my first investment, I had a financial advisor there at the office show me how to buy my first mutual fund. I also bought my first stock, which ended up being a complete flop, but still, I felt good. I felt confident. Like, I'm buying stock now. Like, I'm investing. I'm 20 years old and I'm investing. But the one thing you have to remember, that when I started investing, I wasn't investing hundreds upon hundreds of dollars. I started investing with as little as $25 per month. Could I have afforded more? Yes, I could have. And in fact, I should have invested more, but I still felt good that I was starting with as little as $25. And that mutual fund that I started with, it doesn't even exist anymore. I don't know if they got bought out or they shut it down. Like, it wasn't a great mutual fund. It wasn't horrible. Nonetheless, like, there were so many other options that were better than that one. But once again, it was all about getting started, getting my feet wet, getting used to understanding how mutual funds work and how the stock market works. And it was really just that real world experience that taught me, that showed me how to start investing the right way in my 20s. And that brings me to the first rule of investing in your 20s. And that rule is just freaking start. I don't care where you start investing, just start somewhere. I get so many people that ask me, so many comments ask me, Jeff, where is the best place to start? Do I start with this online broker? Do I start with this bank? Do I start with this app? And my response to all of them, the best place to start is where you're going to open the account and get started. It doesn't matter where you start, just that you do. You just have to start. That's why I shared at the beginning, the mutual fund that I was putting in $25 per month, like, it was a crap mutual fund. It was a crap mutual fund. But just getting started in that fund opened the investment world to me, to where I finally started learning more about it. How to really invest, how to identify what's a good investment, what's a bad investment, you know, we're the ones I should avoid, and we're the ones I need to put more money in. And nowadays, like, there is no excuse to not invest. There are so many different apps. There are so many different platforms. You can even invest your spare change. Yes, you can start with a quarter. You think I'm joking, but I'm not. There's actually investment apps that will invest your spare change. Apps like Digit and Acorns will take your spare change and put it in the stock market. So you don't need $100 a month. You don't even need $25 a month. You can get started with your spare change. Now, if you want to invest even more, there are apps that allow you to invest more, but doesn't mean that you're paying a lot of commissions and fees. One of those apps is Robinhood. So Robinhood allows you to invest with zero commissions. They don't have a minimum account balance, and you can buy stocks and ETFs. Now, with Robinhood, they are limited in some of their offerings. So if you want more flexibility, you can check out another online broker, M1 Finance. So with M1 Finance, they don't have any commissions, any trade costs, but you do have a $100 minimum to get started. But it's just $100. Like, it's not a lot of money to get started investing in the market. I know you can get your hand on one of these. I believe that you can get your hand on one of these. I know it. I know it. And if you're not comfortable with some of those apps where you have to choose your investments, let's say you don't want to choose individual stocks and you want somebody to help you with that, then there are other online platforms like Betterment and Wealthfront where you just decide how you want to invest, how aggressive you want to be, what's your time horizon, and they will choose the investment strategy for you. So I say again, there is no excuse not to get started, just freaking start. All right, the second rule is you have to respect compounding interest. It's crazy to me that compound interest, that whole concept, I didn't learn that until my junior year of college. And I remember the first time I saw one of those tables that showed how much money could grow over a period of time, like it blew me away. Many people don't understand, many people don't appreciate, many people don't respect the power of compounding interest. But if you are in your 20s, this is something that you have to respect. All I'm asking is for a little respect. Let me give you a quick example that shows you why you need to respect compounding interest. So let's say that you are 20 years old and you start investing $300 a month. If you are making 8% return on your money, by the time that you are 60 years old, you will have $1 million. You'll have over $1 million. So now let's look at somebody that waits 10 years to get started. So now you're 30 years old. You waited 10 years. You're still doing $300 a month, making 8% return. By the time you're 60, if you start at 30, you're going to have $440,000. So we're talking a $550,000 difference just because you waited 10 years to get started. Oh, by the way, you only deposited $36,000 in that 10-year period, but that $36,000 grew to be an extra $550,000. That is the power of compounding interest and why it's so important to start right now. All right, the third investment rule is to uncover those golden eggs.
Ooh, let's find out what's in this golden egg. Oh, I like this one, yay.
When it comes to investing, you only know what you know. So if you've never invested, if you've never bought a stock or a mutual fund or opened an account, you don't really understand how it works. In another video, I shared where I taught a 16-year-old that had saved up $500 and showed him how to invest that money and how over his lifetime, he could grow that to be over $500,000. Now, if you watch that video and if you look at the comments, there are some pretty funny ones. Many people are saying like, oh, that's not enough to get started. Or he needs to be investing into something else other than a mutual fund. Or by the time he's 60, he's gonna have all this money and he's gonna be old and almost dead. I mean, it's like, it's just funny what people had to say on that video. But the one thing that nobody commented on, that nobody realized, is that you have a 16-year-old that is starting to invest. He's opening an account, he's putting money into the mutual funds, he's understanding how the stock market works. He is starting so early that he is going to become so familiar with all the different options that exist. And he's going to become an expert investor. He's going to be able to teach other 16-year-olds how to invest and how to become financially free before they're 40 or 50 years old. I mean, this young man is going to be on top of the world. And it's all because he started investing. Listen, you can watch YouTube videos all day. You can read books. You can listen to podcasts about investing. But until you actually start, you're not going to learn what else is out there. All right, the fourth rule on investing in your 20s is to choose tax-free status. Now, this bit of advice contradicts a bit what Dave Ramsey, personal finance expert, radio host, author, has to say. So if you ever read Dave Ramsey's book, Total Money Makeover, when he talks about investing and getting started, he suggests that people start investing with their 401k. So you do your 401k to get the free match. So if they have a 4% match, whatever it is that your company offers, invest to get the free match, to get that free money. After you get your free money, then you go to the Roth IRA and you max that out. So if you get the point where you're putting over $5,000 a year into the Roth, you do that, and then you go back to the 401k. So my advice is a bit different because I suggest that people start with the Roth IRA. Even though if your 401k is offering free money, skip it and choose the Roth. And why is that? My reasoning is this: most people that sign up with their 401k have no idea what they're putting their money into. They might sign up online, they might meet with their HR director and fill out one sheet of paper, and next thing you know, they're on their way, they're putting money into a 401k, and they have no idea where their money is going. But if you open a Roth IRA, you actually have to go and do it, whether that go to a brick and mortar investment place around where you live or going online, setting up an account, and actually having to choose those investments. By having to physically open your own Roth IRA account, you're going to have more skin in the game. You're going to learn so much more than just signing up online, filling out a sheet of paper, and being done with it. So yes, you might be giving up some free money in your 401k, but you're gonna gain so much more in knowledge and experience that's gonna allow you to invest and grow your wealth so much faster. Sorry, Dave, I still love you.
This is ridiculous.
Rule number five is to invest in your number one asset. What is that number one asset? That asset is you. Invest in yourself. I'll admit, early in my 20s, I don't think I really understood what this meant. You know, invest in myself. When I had an opportunity to become a CFP, a certified financial planner, that was some out-of-pocket costs, time, resources that I had to do to get it. But I knew that getting that designation was well worth it, was definitely an investment that was worth it. But the biggest way that I invested into myself in my 20s was reading as many books as I could. I have talked about reading books so much on this channel. You can check out other videos on some of the most inspirational books that I've read. But reading these books, especially in my 20s, when I didn't have parents that knew how to teach me the basics of finance or how to start a business or to become an entrepreneur, by reading these books, it inspired me, it motivated me, it showed me real life situations, real life stories of people that had achieved massive success. And it gave me a roadmap to begin my journey. Another big way that I invested in myself in my 20s was attending conferences. Now, I didn't really know what was the point of attending a conference, but starting off my career as a financial advisor, we would have an annual conference. And I wanted to go to these. I didn't really know why I was going, but after I attended my first one, I got it. When I attended these conferences, I was networking with other financial advisors that had achieved the level of success that I was shooting for. They had breakout sessions of just teaching different principles on whether it becoming a better financial planner or strategies on how to grow your business. I learned so much from these conferences. Like, I went to every single session that I could because I devoured all that information so I could come back and put it into practice. And nowadays, there are so many different ways that you can invest into yourself. This could be joining a paid mastermind group or paying a mentor to mentor you, listening to podcasts, listening to audiobooks, buying courses, just learning, whether that going back to school or taking courses online. Like, there are so many ways to invest into yourself and to get that knowledge that you need to take yourself to the next level. All right, the sixth rule of investing, especially in your 20s, is understanding the power of the side hustle. Now, I have another video where I argue that I make the case that the side hustle is the best investment that you can make for yourself. So why a side hustle? Like, why is that such a big deal, especially in your 20s? Before I answer that, let me ask you this. Do you want to be in control of your future, or do you want someone else to be in control? If you want to be in control, that is what the side hustle can give you. So why is that such a big deal? The side hustle is something that is not going to change your life overnight, but if you are investing time and resources into this side hustle, this side business that eventually produces a healthy income, this gives you so much flexibility, gives you so much power not to be stuck in a dead-end job that you potentially hate. And let's get one thing clear. The side hustle is not a part-time job. So this is not driving for Uber. This is not getting a job at Starbucks or working overtime at your current job. The side hustle is building an asset that could potentially give you passive income down the road. That is the power of the side hustle. A side hustle could be a blog, it could be a YouTube channel, it could be freelancing, social media marketing, graphic design. There are so many different things that a side hustle could be that it can change your life, but you just have to start it. Remember point number one? You just have to start. All right, the seventh rule investing in your 20s is do what the wealthy do. Now, when you start in your 20s, this might be kind of tough, but one of the ways that I was able to really amass a lot of wealth, especially in a tax-deferred status, was opening a self-directed retirement account. Now, I shared this in another video, how the wealthy people, this is how they do this. So when you see mega investors buying real estate and they're buying it in their IRA, and you're wondering, how do they do that? How are they buying real estate in a tax-deferred account? This is how they do it. So if you don't know what a self-directed retirement account is right now, that's okay. At least you're now familiar with it. And as your side hustle grows, as a side business grows, you start to know, okay, this is something that I could consider down the road. So how else do wealthy people invest? Well, This is no surprise, but wealthy people invest into real estate.
Free real estate, I'll pee my pants.
Jim, come get your damn land.
It's a free house!
Jim, I got real estate.
Jim, to get better than this?
Jim!
The house is free!
Jim!
The house is free!
It's a free f***ing house!
It's free real estate.
Now, this is something that I will not proclaim to be an expert in. I have some real estate investments, but there are definitely people that know a lot more about investing in real estate than I do. How I got started investing into real estate is a few different ways. The first of which is real estate notes. So with these real estate notes, I've got a buddy of mine who is an expert real estate investor, and he started raising funds, raising capital to invest into more properties. And with those properties, we basically invest money and he pays us a dividend each month for that investment. With this investment, I'm getting paid 7% interest on my money and I don't have to lift a finger. I don't have to do a thing. I don't have to worry about the property, but if something happens to the property, I do have ownership of that property. So that's how that investment works. I also invest into real estate utilizing Fundrise. Fundrise is an online platform that allows you to invest into real estate properties. And then you have a company, which is Fundrise, that is picking those properties and managing those properties for you. What I love about Fundrise is that it's so similar to the real estate notes in that I just open an account, put my money in, and let them do their thing. With Fundrise, you need $500 to get started. That's it. And you can get started investing into real estate. Now, if you want to up your real estate game and invest into real properties, you need to check out another video with my buddy Travis. So Travis has been able to invest into like 5 or 6 different properties here in the Nashville area, and he is making a killing. He's already turned a profit on one of his properties. He's getting ready to turn a 6-figure profit on another property. He's cash flowing his other rental properties. I mean, he has done an amazing job, and you'll especially love checking out that video because he shares that journey of making that first purchase, buying that first rental property that led him to his other properties. Once again, with Travis, it was all about getting started. So if real estate is something that you're interested in, check out that video and you'll learn some of the basics on how to do it and how to do it right. It doesn't matter where you are in your investment journey, whether you are a complete rookie, you've never invested, you don't know how to start, or if you've been investing for a few years and you still want to learn more. If you're in your 20s, these are 7 rules that can 10X where you're at right now. Heck, we can 100X, depending on how much you're willing to invest and how much you're willing to do the research, do the work and dive in to get started. But as I said throughout this entire video, it's all about getting started. So if you want to invest your spare change with Acorns or Digit, if you want to buy stocks utilizing Robinhood or M1 Finance, or you want somebody like Betterment to choose your investments for you, or maybe you want to get started with real estate, you want to check out Fundrise, whatever that is, the links will be in the description below. Check them out, but most importantly, check them out and get started. This is Jeff Rose reminding you that it's your money, it's your life, and only you can make it awesome. Until next time, y'all. Peace.